electrical touching. I have some very messy with them.
client needs, and we decided to make our own framework. Then this is a new framework, XP3080. This framework includes basically everything for general purpose scanning. We have data class, state drivers, and camera interface, and tracking, and reconstruction, and also display, and also GPU interface. All classes are root-based programming, and operating system independent. You can use Windows or Linux. Just a snapshot of classes. So, all classes are root classes, and documentation is automatically generated thanks to root. And this is transparent for users. Then, for the tracking, we can accommodate several versions of tracking, and user can just switch which tracking you want to use. You can implement by yourself some tracking for short track, neutrons, or any cosmic searches. This is just a screenshot of online data addition. You have tab here, and this is a GUI for the scanner and monitor. So this is a quite simple interface based on root. So we have a nice metal display we call virtual microscope. So I want to show you. Up to now, to observe virtual track, you have to go to the microscope to see the here we have all the images from, this is data from 1 square centimeter. This is in my PC. And you can zoom up and all the detailed data is stored in hard disk. And you can work as if you are playing at the microscope. If you move, data is dynamically loaded, and you can continue. By the way, this is a track from the anti-clockwise annihilations. So, this is very nice for students and also for general public. So this summer we had several summer students. So they enjoy this display and observe what part it is. This was very nice. And not only, yeah. Of course you can use for the measurements, precise measurements. Coming to tracking, so as I said, we need general purpose tracking with bigger angular acceptance. Then this means 8 times larger acceptance in solid angle than opera. This is angular acceptance in azimuthal angle or the acceptance in stellar angle. In opera, it covers only 1.5 steradian. We need to cover 12.6 into 4.5 steradian with angular space, solid angular space. Then we want to detect short tracks. This means finer sampling. The opera uses only 16 frames per view. Now we are taking about 40 frames per view. And then, to detect short tracks, we cannot use a kind of quick algorithm. So we cannot and able to get where tracks start and where tracks stop. Then that can be professionally modified. This to get this information and to kind of disagree, takes 5 times more computation than computation. Then 8 times larger angular acceptance and 10 times more computation. Then we need about 2 orders of magnitude larger computation needed when compared to the operator standard refraction algorithm. Just do some steps. So we implemented kind of 3D filtering. So first we do pixel by pixel gain control and background subtraction to detect pixel noise and pixel gain difference. And then we do the three-dimensional gain clustering.
Pixel by pixel,
even there's no images, pixel by pixel is a little bit different. The grayscale is different. This has to be that. But we won't be minus. This is a, you see the vertical lines.
Right. Yes.
These are the. So I don't use conventional filtering, which is used for the opera ones and songs, because we want to keep the raw data as much as possible for the DDX population. So we don't use high-pass filter here. But we carefully compute the background level and subtract. This is a recognized grains. Our operating algorithm is like this. So we compute, so this is the three-dimensional space, x and z. We compute any two-grain combination in certain volume. In this case, I open 25 micron sphere to find the pattern rates and make a zero track. So each grain, two grain combination make a sheet, and then extrapolate these lines, then count number of grains along these tracks. Then if number of grains along this line is more than a certain value, I say this is a trap. Again, let me show you some display. I was too lazy to make it down here. This is one second data, again. Maybe you cannot see very well. This is a reconstructed grain. Scattered like here there is a small scattering of this track. Then this is successfully reconstructed as a two segment. And later, after analysis, you can reconstruct as a one track. samples from each experiment and use high sensitivity eject. The efficiency of this tracking is so far more or less 100%. All tracks recognized by myself is reconstructed by the relativist. This is the angular distribution of the fields. This is handled as a three-dimensional field data, and this is scatter plot of three x and three y. The all angular this is the cosine theta distribution, and theta is a tangential angle. Here, vertical to the horizontal. And theta is here, c is here. You can see the more or less flat distribution in cosine theta. This means the flat distribution in any solid angle. The efficiency checking is ongoing. So we check with human measurement. Here only about 100 tracks measured by a person, and then we compare the result of tracking, automatic tracking. And then this is result as a function of the angle. Blue is found by algorithm, and empty boxes are measured by a person. There's here only about 100 tracks is here, just only one is missing. And change as a function of angle is like this, it's more or less 100%. This is tracks longer than 10 microns. And, one track I missed, the algorithm missed is below 15 microns. It was very short, near my resume track. I can say the tracking exchange is here. Then, this is an example of the construction of proton tracks evolved by 2.5 millineurons. As you can see, the track is reconstructed. And good thing of this algorithm, you can get the stop and start and stop point of the track. And you can compute the length of the track. Also, you can follow the scatter track as a different set. Okay, now is a demonstration of the algorithm, and then coming to the tracking speed. Well, our goal so far is 1.2 seconds per view. This means about 10 square centimeters per hour. And then data size is 1 megapixel times 40 frames, about 50 megabytes. Field of view is 300 times 250 microns, and this processing includes image filtering, 3D grain reconstruction, and 3D transformation. Then the trial using the high-spec PC is about 10 seconds per view. This is, I can say this is rather fast, but not enough for our purpose. We need about factor 50 times faster system. And then we use the GPU technology. GPU has a big advantage of parallel processing in the thousands of processing units. There's some comment about the history of the GPU in Amazon. So, there was already discussion in early 2000 to use GPU for the tracking. This was discussion between me and WL university colleagues. This is use quantum making implemented in the GPU to use the tracking with conventional tracking algorithm. And then we found that is not enough high speed and we gave up. Then 2006, the library was released by Nvidia, and this was the general purpose library. And then this was widely used in science. In 2008, I restarted to use GPUs, and I also made a suggestion for the collaboration to use the GPUs. Then, as you saw, there is a few successful implementation shown by Fuda and Barry. Then, so again, we started after several interruption. We started the activity and achieved the result. This is our equipment. We have three GPUs here with state-of-the-art GPUs with fast GPUs and powerful power supply for fast memories. So this is nothing special you can buy in the market. Then using this machine, I checked the processing time with a single step programming. This means only one CPU and one GPU is working. The result of one CPU case, so when filtering is 0.6 seconds, CPU cost recognition, 0.2 seconds, 3D tracking is 6 seconds. In total, about 7 seconds is necessary for GPU case. Then the GPU case, the processing of filtering is much more, about the speed factor 25 days. And 3D recognition is factor 8 gain, and tracking is factor 16 games. So, our goal is 0.2 seconds per view. So, this is clearly not enough. Then, we moved from single CPU thread programming to the multi CPU threads and multi GPU programming. So, this is a result. X-axis is the number of CPU threads. This black line, white is the processing time. The black line is on the CPU case. I have a CPU with 6 cores and 12 threads. So, ideal case, the processing time should be smaller as a function of the number of threads up to 12. But after 6-5 sets, the processing time doesn't go shorter anymore. The best result with CPU, only CPU, is about 1.5 seconds per view. And this group meaning that group are use of GPUs, and this part is zoomed on the right figure. This is a result of single GPU, 2 GPU, 3 GPU. And goal is here, 0.2 seconds per view. So with 2 GPU or 3 GPU, I could achieve the goal. This goal. Out of the best result is about 140, 0.14 seconds per view. But out of this, about 50 milliseconds is file I/O time. So, the Yeah, the tracking time is about 0.1 second. Then, starting from this point to the best iterative GPU, I could achieve about faster, 70 times faster system. So this is enough for our purpose for AGSEC experiment. A new framework for general purpose neutron scanning construction is being developed in there. And for fast 4-pi tracking is realized with GPU. This system is being applied for AGIS and neutron projects and other applications to further improvement in processing speed and tracking performance using.
Okay. Question, please. This estimation of timing you have done on which kind of emulsion? Super emulsion?
This is a bit more thick emulsion, 80 micron thickness.
I guess the fog was not so high as
I also scanned the film, but I can process similar speed.
And one more question. On the plot of the number of tracks as a function of angle,
this is this means a complete horizontal track.
Yeah.
And
why?
This is kind of artifact. So horizontal track is reconstructed as several pieces. That's why it's more than.
So each track presented several times.
Yes.
Okay. More questions? Okay, no questions. Thank you to the speaker. Okay, next presentation from Yoshimoto on the super fast automatic motion scanning system.
I'll talk about fast automated immersion scanning system, HDS. I'm Masayo Yoshimoto, principal facilitator is
and other collaboration. As you know, this is our immersion. In Nagoya University, we have been developing new immersion film. Grain density is much higher than previous one. Gelatin gel can be produced by ourselves. Now, pouring facility is under construction. new emulsion is here. Opera type emulsion is here. Of course, you know, so skip. Emulsion layer, thickness of emulsion layer is about 50 micron or more. Depth of field is about 3 micron. So we are we should snap multiple images for 3D tracking. This image is stacked image of my optical microscope. And this is an image of X-ray microscope. As you see, about grain size is about 0.3 micron. So we should optical resolution is required more than 0.5 micron. And this is a raw image which is taken here. Applying FIR filter, erasing the background and leave only silver grains. This is a track recognition method. Of course, you know, explain the take 16 tomographic image by a microscope, see its image to aim at the specific angle tracks. Sum up and find signal of tracks. This is invited by Niva. Professor Niva. This is a history of emulsion reader system in Nagoya. We are developing each system every experiment. This is track selector, nuclear track selector, and nuclear track selector. But we need innovation has been required for the next generation system. This is a version of scanning speed. We developed 100 times faster than UTS. This is a method. We should overcome the bottleneck of the image acquisition. So we use ultra high speed camera and taking image taken by flow shot and optimizing field of view. So this in this method we move objective evidence this direction. We have achieved
72 square centimeters per hour. This is a super nuclear sector. Five SUTS were productive in order to perform opera experiment. Reader capability of one SUTS is 20 square meters, but yeah. But there is a further possibility in nuclear immersion. This is an example of muon radiography. In order to achieve a more time resolution and more angular resolution, we need more immersion plates scanning them. About 100 square meters. Next application is here. This is a grand project, gamma ray telescope. For this project, for first step, 2011 following experiment was performed, and next year we are planning at early spring in Australia. And from 2015, we want to start a scientific observation. For this observation, we need several thousand square meters. So we need more immersion radar system. And this is a start application. We are planning that one size with nuclear immersion. This is already a thought. So finally, we need to realize the target of mass 1 ton, about 4,000 square meter. Then we need a few order of magnitude speeds than SUTS. So we HES new generation system HES was designed at 100 times faster and achieve 2,000 square meter per year. Concept of HES is here. It is difficult to drive objective lens much more quickly, but field of view can be few orders of magnitude larger. This is a photo, a recent photo of HES. Here, computer and GPU board. And this is a optical system. And X, Y, Z, high precision and speed state. I will explain these details. This is enormous objective lens, this one. And I mean, field of view is 5 by 5 millimeter. Very large area. Previous system of field of view is here, 0.2 millimeter by 0.2 millimeter. This HES FOV is 600 times larger. But we suppress TV distortion and curvature. And we divide the FOV into 72 parts. We need a sensor of 2 megapixel and 300 frames per second. This is a specially ordered mosaic image. 12 sensors is here. And but there is a gap, sensor gap. So we use a beam splitter and set this window, set this one, six cameras, and combine we achieved five by five square meter field of view. Yes.
So,
this is HS objective lens and moving stage. And do you know this stage moving up and down? Can you see? this is a bit slow, but the field of view is 600 times larger, so very, very fast.
Speed of 300 megabytes.
prepare 36 types. Total of data is 2.6 terabyte per plate at the hotel. This is big data. This is a data flow of HCS. First, sensor output raw image, and the image filter output finalized image. So this is megabyte to 5 megabyte. And GPU time is this one. And track recognition output or tracks. GPU time is 20 to 50 milliseconds. And clustering output micro tracks and storage stuff. In this time, output pixel count for surface recognition. This is a stage control chart. Here, master computer, stage controller. The stage controller has a motor, and here's the drive. There is two sensors and one computer. Master computer, from master computer, broadcast stage position and actuator status and trigger time for image capture. And feedback, pixel count for surface detection. Then data, all of data is about to average 200 megabyte per second per hour. Then we are preparing some components. This is a status 2011. We prepare object lens and motors for the XYZ axis and piezo actuator for the axis. This year's May, half of camera and computer become ready. And from this time, scanning test for various immersion credits. And this is the total speed. Here, practical speed is 300 square centimeter per hour. I did a scanning test at this speed, but already installed this time at this speed, and final goal is 9,000 square centimeter. SUD speed is here, so now we are four times speeder than SUD. And result, I use a new type of immersion. Grain density is 50, and for density is 3. We connecting the tracks in one ski, and I checked whether this track exists or not. The efficiency is 98%, 98%, and this is almost same as the previous system. This is angle deviation. Horizontal axis is angle difference and number. And this is the X projection and Y projection. We checked this difference. Prediction flux was meant by breaks, up breaks and under breaks. So this sigma is almost same as SUTS.
So which beam are you using? Which beam? Pitch to
particles. This is this is not beam, cosmic wave, and we expose 2,000 meter mountain.
This is not
so
only beam, not
yes.
Including.
This includes low energy. And what we can do with HES? We have emulsion archive project. The project is to read all emulsion and convert to the data. In near future, we will scan a lot of emulsion with HES, but requirement is here. First, all emulsion existing around the world, and money and manpower for running. And identify a specification of drugs and images. Last, dream for science. I want to hold, for example, JC, Randu, or some experience, emulsion, want to read that. Yes. So this is the summary and prospect. We are developing HES, which is 100 times faster. And scanning at the speed of 300 centimeter power is practical. And the efficiency and angle resolution are almost same as previous system. HES is working for new radioactive and brain project and the quantum search. All cameras and computers will be installed this year. That's all. Thank you.
Question, please.
Yes. So, maybe I missed. How many working distance it was in depth?
Working distance is 1.5 millimeter, but I think 1 millimeter thickness can read out.
So you can read out also force motions. You can read out also force motions, yes?
Yeah.
And donut. Horus and donut.
Yeah. Yes.
And relativistic nuclei.
More questions?
Yes. This HES is designed angle range is on the 100 theta one. So under 100 theta one, GPU time is 20 milliseconds. So this is
is it fresh to change algorithms?
Yes.
You can implement many kinds of algorithms.
So I'm right. emulsion method or algorithm. Sometimes I try other drug emulsion methods. Yeah.
You take 16 layers.
Yes, now 16, but we can more images. But depth of field is about 3 micron, and a little worse than SUPs. So if we more layer, we need to expand. Yes.
So your tracking algorithm is the same as Intes in principle. This basic tracking algorithm. It's the same as Intes.
Yes, we are from basic one. And now
so, if no questions, let's thank the speaker. So, next presentation is from Morishima and Hiro, development of one radioactive system with nuclear reaction.
I talk about development of muon radiography system with nuclear emulsion. So the principle of muon radiography is shown in this figure. So the cosmic muon come from all directions on the ground, and the principle of muon radiography is the measurement of the absorption of cosmic muon inside matter. So the measurement of the muon flux in each direction. So we know the matter density in each direction. So we can get the absorption potential by the muon flux in each direction. So you know nuclear emulsion properties. So nuclear emulsion is three-dimensional tracking spectra and very high spatial resolution. And this 2 points is very important for the application of muon radiography. So nuclear emulsion is a solid state detector, so no need of power supply, and very flexible shape and size, and very lightweight. So these properties have a very good advantage for muon radiography in field observation. So the target of muon radiography is the target of muon radiography. So past science, so volcano and fault and resource exploration. And another target is plants, for example, nuclear reactor and glass furnace inside the structure. And another subject, our target is the archaeological target, so for example, pyramid. And another target is the large scale concrete structure to see inside the structure. And this is the overview of neural system we are developing. So we are developing the technologies of so nuclear immersion and scanning technology and analysis technology. And we are establishing the methodology of neural system. So now, first we design data suitable for the observation target and it enables in the environment around the observation point. And then we will produce the immersion and power the immersion across the table. And we will construct the immersion detector. And then we will install the nuclear immersion detector in the observation point and expose. And the detector was will be exposed. And after then we will do chemical development and scan. And we will reconstruct these tracks and search muon tracks and calculate muon tracks and calculate matter densities. So I will show you this. First, I will show you this reconstruction, scanning and reconstruction method by using the reactor core example. And then I will show you the immersion production status of our laboratory. So now we are developing the muon radiography of reactor core. So because now unfortunately, Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant was damaged by tsunami and by big earthquake and tsunami in 2011. So, up to now, we cannot see inside of the reactor. So, the reactor core is up. Our estimation about this reactor core is melted down, but where is reactor core exists or and distribution and the core size is not understood at all. So we are proposing the muon radiography for searching inside of the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear reactor. So we have conducted a test experiment using using experimental first reactor JoJo. So this is the perceptual view of JoJo plant. So this green line is ground level, and this red line shows the reactor vessel, and nuclear immersion is placed here. So this is perceptual view of reactor vessel and detector position. So this red color shows the core structure. So this density is about 6 gram per square centimeter per cube. And this yellow shows the liquid sodium. So this density is less than 1 gram. And this gray zone shows the carbon, and black zone shows the concrete. And this picture shows the experiment setup of the nuclear immersion detector. And we placed two detectors on the floor. This theta A is just under the base L, and B is B, and the distance between A and B is about 1 meter. So, and exposure time is about 21 days. And muon come from, if muon come from this direction, the muon pass through the carbon and concrete. And if come from this direction, the muon is more absorbed than this direction. And if this passing through this this line, muon is more translate. So we can detect the this effect by detection of the muon flux in each amplitude. And this is the result of this experiment. So this shows the, this red shows the reactor core, and yellow shows the surface. And this is shows the muon flux and distribution. And this is raw data, and this is the muon flux, binding muon flux image. So you can see the red part is more detected muon angle, and yellow is yellow and blue is lower flux. And this yellow part is this yellow direction is this core direction, and this red direction is this yellow sodium direction. And we will proceed the collection of a collection for the efficiency of our scanning system. So this is the raw data, and this is our scanning efficiency map and distribution. And this is collected after collected map. And then we compare with cosmic wave muon flux. So this is this shows the angular distribution of incident cosmic wave muon at the detector position. And this is our detected muon flux. So we can calculate the angular distribution of transmission rate in each eye. And then we will convert from absorption information to the mother density information. So after this process, we can get angular distribution of the mother density. So this is the result of two positions. So this position A shows just under the reactor, and B shows the this position. And this red color shows the high matter density direction, and blue is low matter density region. And this cross point is vertical direction on the floor. So this direction is parallel to this direction. So you can see the red part in the center in position A. So this matter density is from reactor 4, and around this region you can see blue part. So this blue part direction is consistent with this yellow liquid sodium direction. So this direction is low order density. And in the position B, this high matter density direction is shifted to 50 about 0.1 radian. So this 0.1 radian is consistent with the detector position difference. And another structure is almost the same as A. And yes, so so this result shows we have detected this reactor core structure by using nuclear emulsion. And we have simulated the explanation. We have simulated the density distribution of the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. The left figure shows the normal situation. Normal situation is the reactor core is not damaged. And right picture shows the melted down situation. So this situation means the melted core was melted down. So this red color shows the high matter density and blue is low matter density. And we can see this red part shows the reactor core. And this shape which shows the pressure vessel. And this shape shows the floor, and this shape shows the wall, and so on. And this matter concentration region shows the used core material solid book. So we are estimating the nuclear core observation sensitivity by using this simulation. So if core size is 1 cubic square meter, so we can detect this size nuclear core by exposing this scale. So this scale means delta area by exposure time. So we need 1 square meter by 1 week for observation of this core. So we need several square meter, this is not film, square meter detector for this application. And now we are developing this product, nuclear emulsion production and growing emulsion, and the speed up emulsion constructing. We speed up the production speed. I show you this data. So now we are. In our group have the production machine, and now we are using this machine for production. So this production speed is about 30 opera fields per day. So this area is 0.3 square meter. So if we made 3 batch per day, we can make the 1 square meter per day by using this machine. And this is the performance of new nuclear emulsion gel. So this shows the this shows the electron beam exposed in the nuclear emulsion. And this is this value shows the volume occupancy of HBR crystal in the gel. And this shows the 30% volume occupancy of HBR crystal. And if in this situation we have achieved 33 grains per 100 square meter, per 1 micron. So this is the sensitivity. And now we are increasing the volume occupancy in the emulsion gel, in the depth. So now we have achieved 48 grain per 100 micron. So this value is 1.5 times higher sensitivity than graphene. So this is our achievement. And now we are developing the flying emulsion gel. So I will show you how to make the emulsion detector. So first we measure the weight emulsion gel and melt the gel, and we pour the gel onto the plastic case, and this plastic case was coated there. Coated by the gelatin, and this is the plus. Spread this emulsion and onto the face. And in this process, we are tuning the emulsion gel property, so viscosity and the surface tension. And then we will dry the emulsion gel. So in this process, we are tuning. We are tuning the drying condition, humidity and temperature and wind. So in this state, by using this state, we can achieve, make a two open field. And now we have constructed the emulsion cooling facility at the university. So we can produce the 10 open film in parallel. And this is of course the attack room and temperature control, humidity control was done. And this is drying shape. So by using this facility, we can produce the 1 square meter per 4 days. But it is not enough speed, so now we are planning to increase the speed of 1 square meter per day. So now we are enlarging the drying stage. This size is about 50 centimeter by 50 centimeter. So this, by using this stage, our production speed is 5 times. And this is our emulsion. So we need to check the emulsion layer thickness and the emulsion distortion and improvement of sensitivity and signal modulation. So this is the thickness distribution of emulsion layer by our method. So this is the thickness two-dimensional distribution. And this is the almost all, this size is the same as the graphene. And this value is, this value is micron. So, and this is the histogram of this emulsion sequence. And this is the graphene sequence distribution. So now emulsion is worse than graphene, but our requirement is this 20 micron this line. So the uniformity thickness is about 10 micron, but it is enough performance for the neural network. And we will check, we have checked the trunk measurement accuracy in nuclear module data. So this is the muon trunk, and we have measured this trunk angular resolution by our system. So this is the result. Opera film, by using opera film, we have achieved about 15 millimeter, and also we have achieved we have achieved 50 million by using our network model. So the margin distortion is the equivalent value to the opera field. And finally, we have checked the performance of discrimination of gamma ray traps. So for muon radiography, background of muon radiography is gamma ray traps. So this, this shows this vertical axis shows the pulse height and horizontal axis the angular difference quality. So electron tracks is worse angular difference quality, and but nuclear muon is good angular difference quality. So we can separate by using this information, but opera film is not so good separated. So this region is cosmic ray muon, and electron gamma ray tracks is here. But by using Nagoya Marjo, we can create separate between cosmic muon and electron tracks. And by using this emulsion, we have estimated, we have check the efficiency, tracking efficiency. So this red color shows the Nagoya margin and the blue color shows the opera field. So you can see clearly Nagoya margin is better. And almost and Nagoya margin achieved about more than 95% in all and we have cosmic ray muon, we have conducted the test exposure on the rooftop of the Nagoya University. So, by in this is that shows the clearly muon flux by using only one emulsion plate, because this this emulsion is very good. And this is the future project of production speed. So about the emulsion gel production, so now we are planning to construct a three-fold scale emulsion gel production machine. So design was fixed and in our schedule, operation test will be started. December this year. So by using this machine, we can produce the 1 square meter per batch. And what the emulsion point, now we are designing the automated emulsion point machine. So by using this automated machine, we will achieve the speed up to 10 square meter per day. So this is the conclusion. Thank you very much.
Question, please.
May I ask how you covered emulsion? You prepare emulsion film directly as opera. So top layers with thickness 44 microns and bottom layers 44.
In now we are.
Auto times.
In now we made the thickness more than 50 micro.
50 micro,
more than 50 micro.
Not the same opera.
Yeah. Not the same opera, but we can control the thickness.
You prepare one layer with thickness 50 micron during one step.
Yes.
After the dry,
yes.
Return and again.
Yes.
Скажите, что хотите спросить.
Вот это, продолжи.
This is very nice question. So about Fukushima, where are you planning to put?
Where? Outside of the building.
So the it's enough. So enough near to see the structure.
Yes. Simulation is detector position. Detector is placed far away from 20 meters. So this building size is about 20 meters. So this is real situation.
Sorry. What about radiation background? You plan to use muon radiography in nuclear power plant. What about radiation background during 1 week? How many?
So, without theory, for the radiation, we need radiation theory. For example. For example, complete or
on top of the
ship. If we without radiation shielding, we cannot use nuclear margin. Because about 1 hour, the radiation level is about 1 millisievert per hour around this period. So we need radiation shielding. For example, red material.
And how much of red do you need for 1 week?
We estimate about 5 centimeters. More 5 centimeters.
Also a question, maybe connected with previous reporter. You prepare film with opera size. In previous report we listened that new track selector possible to treatment all emulsion is a wall. It means that porous emulsion, which has sides 40 centimeters, is possible to mount to the stage for Nutrax selector. Why? Why you continue so small piece and don't prepare a large size?
We can make large size emulsion, but Nutrax selector stage is glass size is
also small.
Yes. Also small.
Why?
I think it's needed that for super complex selector, it's moving to a state is moved by this drive, so it could not be too big and too heavy.
Yes. What about previous?
I think it will be cut. It.
Oh, of course.
Am I right? So to scan the porous emulsions, you need just to cut them to open a size pieces.
Yes. I'm not sure. Also, will be agreed to cut.
No cut, we set one by one. Yeah.
I see. Not cut.
Not cut.
Yeah.
Of course, not cut.
It's an option. Between for a when to cut.
Yes.
To cut.
Yes. You see, do you have some preliminary agreement with Japan government as concerned investigation of Fukushima? Sorry.
Not yet. We have not yet get the government support. But now we are starting the study of Fukushima Daiichi radiography with Toshiba company.
Thank you.
More questions? Okay, if more questions, let's finish.